students, we are going to study about the clinical examination of arterial valves and how to perform. So the artery chosen routinely is radial artery. So the arm, the forearm should be in a semi-prone position. The wrist should be semi-flexed. Now you have to use your three fingers for clinical examination of arterial valves. So tip the three fingers on the radial artery and try to feel the artery. This distal finger is used for any obliteration of any retrograde pulsation, whereas the middle finger is actually used for feeling of the artery. So once you feel the pulse, first is rate. So you have to measure the rate for 1 complete minute. Okay, and then after measuring for 1 complete minute, note down in your journal. Next thing that you have to see is the rhythm. Whether the pulse is regular, whether it is coming at regular interval. If it is regular, just write down regular in your journals. Then we have to see for force. For force, you have to use this index finger. How much force is required to be applied with the index finger so that no pulse is felt with the middle finger? This is known as force. So I will apply pressure with the index finger so that no pulse is felt with the middle finger. Okay. So this will give you an estimate of force, and this force ideally should be moderate. Okay. Now we have to see for the tension. Okay. So the tension is nothing but feel of the artery between the two beats. So this normally the tension should be moderate. Next is condition of the vessel wall. Now see, for seeing the condition of the vessel wall, we have to empty the blood vessel first. So with the help of these two fingers, just empty the radial pulse and just roll this middle finger over the radial artery and try to feel the condition of the vessel wall. Okay, normally it should be very elastic in nature. In this way you have to feel. Next is we have to see for pulse at other sides. So apart from facial, apart from this radial artery, other sides are superficial temporal, then facial artery, just katuni that chava, pinch that, which is felt at the anterior border of the masseter. This is the facial artery. Next is the carotid artery. Of course, we have seen the radial artery. We can palpate for femoral artery at this in this inguinal region. Similarly, we can feel for popliteal artery in the popliteal fossa, and this dorsal spheris artery, which can be felt in this in the gap between the first and the second metatarsals. Okay, so this is in this way you can see for pulses at other sides. And the last point is that we have to check for equity on both sides. So sir, can you sit up? For checking the equity on both sides, you have to check simultaneously in identical arteries on both sides. So check for superficial temporal artery. Find out whether the pulse is bilaterally equal and or not. Check for facial artery, or the sala, at the anterior border of the masseter. One word of caution, never check carotid artery simultaneously. Okay, we don't want the patient to land up in syncope. So this is the only exception that one should not check for carotid artery simultaneously. So you can only check one at a time. Okay, then you have to check, you can check for radial pulse simultaneously. You can check for popliteal artery simultaneously. Similarly, you can check for dorsal spheris simultaneously. So these are the other sites where one can check for bilateral equivalent. And that we have to see is the volume. So you have to keep three fingers on the radial artery. Volume is nothing but the upliftment given to this middle finger. So this volume ideally should be moderate. Okay. So in this way all the parameters of pulse can be judged.